I don't think that you're ready for this, and I know a lot of you aren't gonna like what I'm doing here, but here's a teaser. You should fear these. If you thought that these were bad, I have news for you.
Shut them down. Trip. Zone A lost. Zone C captured. You have a lot.
2 for 1.
Yes. 3 down. Fantastic work. Zone C lost. Zone A captured. You have zone advantage. Triple down. Fantastic work.
Caliban's hand is crazy. It's straight up nuts. In this review, I want to talk about what they do and importantly, how to use them. I see a lot of people not using them right. That ends here today. The exotic perk, Roast 'em. The proximity knife scorches targets, it damages with explosions, or ignites targets on a direct hit. After throwing a proximity knife, you gain increased melee regeneration until the knife explodes. All of this coexists, and guys, ignitions that are souped up with mods, and I'm gonna get into those, how to set it up, they're nukes. They spread near 11 meters. This right here is the best AoE collateral distance in the game. Previously, it was CloudStrike. That AoE damage list, as far as collateral distance overall damage, it's number one, Caliban's Hand. CloudStrike, Ace of Spades with Chromatic Fire, the Severance Enclosure Bonk Hammer, Chromatic Fire, then Dragonfly. And I've been showing you some PvP. There's a lot more to that. We're gonna get more into that. But this exotic is also really good at PvE. We have a very good exotic on our hands. You can fit in all the Solar 3.0 things into it, and even Warmind cells if you want to. This is more of an add deletion deal. It does spread ignitions to higher tier enemies, but for that sustained damage on a target, on Gunslinger, the Omkar and Nadeslinger is gonna be better. There's a card at the top right of the screen if you haven't seen that yet, but let's get into it. First things first, these have PvE and PvP setups. For the Crucible, I do suggest to make them stasis. When you make them stasis, you add in melee kickstart. This is gonna help the second part of the perk, I'm gonna get into that in a moment, but if you want these for PvE, make them void or solar. Reason being, you can throw a lot more knives in PvE. For void gloves, you have focusing strike. You get class ability energy when you cause damage with your melee attack, so if you want your class ability up, you go this route. Or you can make them solar for impact induction. Causing damage with a melee attack reduces your grenade cooldown. So that's a path to get them both fast. Let's talk about this ignition. The ignition happens on a final blow. That's what you're seeing in PvP. You're gonna be seeing in PvE. Mission critical for the Crucible, you need to land a final blow. When you do that, they ignite, explode, scorch spreads, it will happen to another enemy, ignition, and so on. To do this, you can do it a number of ways. I've done it with Crimson, I've done it with Last Word, as long as it's a final blow. But pound for pound, the best is a waveframe launcher, and Dead Messenger fills the shoes the best. You can go other waveframes, but Dead Messenger is fast, it is wide, it gets the job done. Now on to another part. You're using the explosive knife. That's what this exotic involves. It has proximity. So even though it says with direct hits, it really means final blow. So you can shoot the wave on the ground, follow up with the knife. That knife doesn't have to impact them. It just has to be next to them because Dead Messenger does enough damage. And when that knife is stuck in the ground, proximity happens, its little explosion, that's enough to get a final blow and that will proc the perk. And when that happens, a nuke goes off in the area. Gotta be a final blow. You could use any weapon, but the wave frames, let me tell you, that's the way. The second part of the perk is after throwing the proximity knife, you gain increased melee regeneration until the knife explodes. I do recommend max tier 10 strength. And what's nice, let's remember, you get plus 20 strength from Radiant Light. On the Solar subclass, Ember of Eruption and Ember of Combustion both give plus 10 strength. So out of the gate, just with the mod slot in, some fragments, you have plus 40 strength. It can be done. So with 10 tier strength, that's the fastest knife possible. It's on a 39 second cooldown. When you have melee kickstart, after you throw that explosive knife, you get a little bit of energy. So it's about a 35 second cooldown. The beautiful part here, and I'm gonna show it in some trials gameplay later too. Say that you go for that knife final blow to proc the exotic perk. Roast him. It misses. It didn't roast anything. Say that enemy was downed by you or an ally got him, the knife just sits there. So it's basically a little trap now. But while it's in the ground, your melee generation is super fast. It takes about 12 seconds to come back. That's after you throw the melee, melee kickstart gets a little bit. If not, it's gonna be about 15, 16 seconds. So I've been playing around that failed knife. because that knife, if it gets a final blow, it will cause the ignition and cause Caliban to go off. Same situation right here, it's a failed knife. It's okay because I have a fast cooldown to get it back. So I'm gonna play around it. Well, two enemies really wanted me dead, so I went back to the knife, got off a dead messenger, and that knife got the final blow on one, ignited, took care of the other. Pretty cool. Things do switch around, but I do have the same aspects and fragments for PvE and PvP. It does switch up though. But for the Crucible, the play loop, the hunter kit using this exotic is just excellent. On your mark, we have three fragment slots. Precision final blows grant you and nearby allies increased handling and reload speed, stacks of times three. Basically a watered down dragon shadow. That's always good, for free. It's amazing, and when you dodge, you immediately go to times three. Knock them down. Solar supers are enhanced, blade barrage is a monster. But why we're using it, while radiant final blows with your equipped knife fully refunds your melee energy. You need the explosive knife. I am running gambler's dodge, that way I can dodge next to enemies, get my knife back, and a trip mine. Any grenade will work, healing, thermite, anything, and you can combo a thermite to proximity knife. Keep that in mind. Now for the fragments, there is a healing way and a way to go all in. For all in, char, solar ignition spreads scorch to affected targets. Ashes, you apply more scorch stacks to targets. Eruption, your solar ignitions have an increased area of effect. Combustion, final blows with your solar super cause targets to ignite. And I use this for the Crucible with six shooter golden gun, because six shooter golden gun, when you pop it, it feels like at any moment, anytime, you get a seventh column. And then for the last one, torches. Powered melee attacks against combatants make you and nearby allies radiant. So if you don't want combustion, run Empyrean. Solar weapon or ability final blows, like this knife, extend the duration of restoration and radiant effects applied to you. It has to be the knife. For the mods, PvP wise, super simple. Do all the things that you need to with Radiant Light, powerful friends for the stat bumps. But to pair on top of all of this, we have the fragment for ignitions that spreads scorch. We have another fragment that increases the area of effect of the ignition. So to top it off, solar fulmination. It costs 3 energy for your class item. Your ignitions do increased damage in an increased radius. So this mod is massive. It makes it a massive AoE. But in turn, this mod can take you down. And I can say, it gets way more collaterals than it takes me out. But just know that if you're a little low health, it can take you out. If you don't have this on, not so much. But I do recommend that you do have fulmination. It's really strong. So for the Crucible, the play loop, really cool. Because with the aspects, fragments, how the solar kit works, when you get that knife final blow, you become radiant. Since you became radiant, you get the knife back. And a lot of the time, you dodge to get the knife with gambler's dodge. Or at some point, you just simply dodge, you know, 100 things. When you do that, you go to times 3 on your mark, which means for dead messenger, you get a fast reload, fast handling. There's an opportunity to just loop the knife. Even if you run out of ammo with your special weapon, you could use your primary, get a couple body shots or a headshot, still finish with the knife and keep the loop going. I even went flawless with this. It made a lot of plays. Sure, the collaterals happened, and it's really good on maps with close quarters, tight quarters. It excels. But what also made a ton of plays was the trap knife. You know, the failed knife. It would be in that area, I would throw the combination, maybe they got away, but it would sit there. And they would get weak, try to get away, but they would run right back into the knife. Or maybe they would go for a res and the knife would be there. When it gets that final blow, it ignites. It made a ton of plays. And side note here, you've been seeing it. I really enjoy these. Like, I think I'm going to main these this season for the Crucible. It's very strong, very satisfying. And this mod setup works for PvE. We're gonna add more things on your armor, but there's also a healing way. You can slot in Classy Restoration and a healing grenade. Classy Restoration, activating your solar subclass abilities, grants you restoration. It only costs 6. You can pair it with solar fulmination, but you would take off eruption and combustion and add in Empyrean, the solar weapon and ability final blows, extend the duration of restoration, and radiant, and then soulless. Radiant and restoration effects apply, do you have increased duration? This is where we get into PvE, and I have a big problem with PvE. For your mods, you can do a number of things. Warm mind cells work, wrath burning, the full kit. Wells are great though. As an example, I have melee well maker, elemental charge, so when I pick up a solar well, I get charged with light. Font of might for my solar weapon, heavy handed. So when I throw that knife and it misses, I get back 50% of it, and then Caliban's second perk gets a fast regen to take it the rest of the way. And then Classy Restoration and Fulmination. All these solar builds are extremely good with incandescent weapons, similar to something like this Mida Mini with Grave Robber incandescent. Those melee final blows refill the mag. Here's the issue though. Things like this have been weird between the PvE and PvP sandbox when it pertains to a certain kill trigger. Like in PvP back in the day, Bottom Tree Dawn, Yoden would get a combustion final blow, and you can get collaterals with that explosion. But not in PvE. Severance Enclosure, the Bonk Hammer. Even if it was 30 meters away where you got that final blow with the hammer, it would cause an explosion. But not in PvE. In PvE, wherever you get that bonk kill, it comes from you. So when it comes to this knife, I've shown for about 9 minutes so far that this knife can be next to an enemy. You can get the final blow with the explosion. It will proc Radiant, it'll proc knock him down, and you get that knife right back. But in PvE, it has to be the actual knife final blow. And if you do that, great. You're gonna get the knife back, you're gonna nuke the area. But unlike PvP, if the explosion gets the final blow, nothing. That sucks. No ignite, nothing. But at the core of it, it is good. It's an add clear monster, and as you're doing it, you can ignite higher tier targets. But compared to the Ahamkara build, that's gonna be better, I think. Because of the constant chaining and juggling, you can do it so much, you make ignitions. And even though this exotic starts with ignitions, out of the gate, that makes it good. But Ahamkara is just sustained looping ongoing. But what's nice is you do have a choice here. If there's a modifier where your grenades do more damage, Ahamkara. There's a modifier, Brawler, where melees do more damage, you have Caliban's Hand. It's a very fun exotic to mess around with in PvE. At the heart of it, it's good. But those two things, number one, not having the explosions trigger the ignition to trigger your kit, it's not good. And two, Ahamkara exists with its loop. You would need a situation like Brawler. But yes, one more time in the end, I think it's a very good exotic, and I find more value in PvP. There's a learning curve to it in there. It takes a few games to get the hang of it, but once you do, you can do this. I promise. I get about 8 to 10 knife final blows a game once I started pairing it with the Waveframe launcher. Then, of course, a lot of those are going to have collaterals. If you have them and haven't been doing what you've been seeing in this video, you're missing out. Go try it. If you're new here, remember to hit the subscribe button, and if you are subscribed, thank you so much for your support. If you're looking to buy a new PC, I am partnered with Apex Gaming PCs. Use my code COOLGUY. There's a link down right at the top of the description, and you can save up to $250 off of your order. I think that these are great. Huge play potential. I want to hear your thoughts. And oh yeah, before I forget, the RGB shader, photo finish, totally changes the color of the armor piece. So if you have some other ornaments that change colors, slap it all on your character. Thank you for watching, and until the next one, I am COOLGUY.